يا لغتي عربية حسبي بأنك منطقي وبياني.
Now we are going to discuss about the camel evolution. It belongs to class Mammalia, subclass Theria, infraclass Eutheria, and the order Artiodactyla. The order Artiodactyla are basically the even-toed mammals or the hoofed mammals. Third and the fourth digits are present, which carry the whole body weight, and the first, second, and the fifth digits are absent. Have two horns with a bony horn core. Metacarpals and the metatarsals are fused to form a long bone called cannon bone. Premolars are simpler in outline than the molars. Double pulley astragalus bone is present in the joints. Artiodactyla has three suborders, Suinia, Ruminantia, and the Tylopoda. The suborder Tylopoda has family Camelidae, which has two genera, the Camelus and the Lama. Evidently, North America was the major center of dispersal and evolution of the camels. They were common in North America in the late Eocene. This is the camel evolution chart. You can see the increasing body size and also the size of the skull with the limbs. The first one is the Protylopus. The earliest known camel lived in the North America 40 to 50 million years ago during the Eocene. The dental formula of the Protylopus is 3 incisors, 1 canine, 4 premolars and the 3 molars. The total number of teeth were 44. It had 4 toes, the diastema was absent and its size was just like the pig. Protomerex. Protomerex lived in Oligocene of the North America. It was two-toed camel and the dental formula was 3 incisors, 1 canine, 4 premolar and the 3 molars. And in its fossil, first and a second incisor were supposed. Two other side branches evolved from the Protomerex along with the Procamelus. These branches are Stenomylus and the LT Camelus. Both Stenomylus and the LT Camelus became extinct without further radiation. The Stenomylus originated from the Protomerex in the Miocene of the North America. Stenomylus had small legs. It was very similar to the present-day gazelle. It was a very fast-running camel. It had primitive mammalian dentition, that is the 3 incisors, 1 canine, 4 premolars and the 3 molars. It was a progressive camel in the development of post-orbital bar. LT Camelus was a large camel with a thin long legs. It had a body size similar to the giraffe and also called as giraffe camel, and adapted for browsing on the tall trees. And as you can see, its long neck in the hair diagram. The LT Camelus has been considered as a progressive camel, not due to its large body size, but due to the reduction in incisors. The dental formula of LT Camelus is 1 incisor in the upper jaw, 1 canine, 4 premolars and the 3 molars, while in the lower jaw, 3 incisors, 1 canine, 4 premolars and 3 molars. The total number of teeth were 40. Procamelus. It was observed in Miocene. Metacarpals and the metatarsals were fused to form a large bone called cannon bone, and this cannon bone has a separate articulation with the two digits. Procamelus, the reduction in dentition took place and the two incisors have been lost. Dental formula was 1 incisor, 1 canine, 4 premolars and 3 molars in the upper jaw. In the place of incisors, they were developed a horny pad working against the spoon-shaped incisors. Procamelus gave rise to Philochunia. Here is the comparison between the camel and the deer. Philochunia, the fossil of its fossil was discovered from Pliocene of the North America, and the camel is smaller than the Procamelus and did not have hump. The reduction in the number of incisors and the premolars in the upper jaw and also in the premolar of the lower jaw, as you can see in the dental formula. Camelus was the last native camel in the North America, and it got extinct along with the horses, bears, mammoths, mastodons, ground sloths and the saber-toothed cats. This is the camel evolutionary chart. As you can see, the first one is a Protypus, second one is Protomerex, and from the Protomerex, Procamelus, Stenomyelus, and the Articamelus originated, and from the Procamelus, Plechunia was originated, and then Camelus and the Lemma. The Lemma has two species, Vicugna and the Lemma. Vicugna live in mountains and rocks, while the Lemma lives in deserts, and it forms groups comprising two females and a single male that hold a territory. Lemma is smaller in size and it do not have hump. It have long hairs to protect themselves from the cold conditions. Camelus has two species, Dromedarus, which is single humped, and the Bacterianus, which is double hump. And they have long hairs while cold climate, live in deserts and mountains. It also forms the groups, and the camels are larger than the lemma. The bark of the camel is known as rock and is similar to the giraffe. Fore and hind feet of one side leave the ground together. Hooves are absent, and in place of hooves, nails are present. Lateral digits are present. Feet spread sideways to help camel walk on the soft sand, and upper incisors are reduced. Lower incisors are very strong, broad, and spoon-shaped. Here you can see different breeds. This is the dromedary camel classification, Bacterian camel classification, and this is a simple review that how from the North America the evolutionary stages of camel migrated through different land bridges. This is the same stuff. And evolutionary trends of camels: reduction of incisors and premolars, browser to grazer, formation of hump, formation of cannon bone, increased size, foot spread sideways to help camel on soft sand, hooves replaced by nails and a pad, absence of hooves in living camels, and close post-orbital bar. Thank you.